Hey everyone, I'm Annabelle, and I'm here today to share a short guide on how to use Asana for beginners. In this video, we're going to cover Asana's benefits, use cases, and a short tutorial on how to get started. If you didn't know already, Asana is one of the most powerful project management apps on the market. It allows individuals and teams to track, organize, and manage complex projects all in one place. It's a game changer for any team wanting to manage a project with more than one layer to it. Now, let's talk about the benefits. Firstly, Asana saves loads of time by decreasing meetings. According to Asana's website, 65% of customers say Asana has reduced the amount of emails and status meetings with their teams. Now imagine how much time you could get back in the day if you didn't have back-to-back status meetings for hours on end. Second is collaboration. With any size team, accountability and transparency are so important in having smooth collaboration. With Asana, it's easy to effectively collaborate because teammates have full transparency of which project each person is working on. For example, they can check in on progress they've made, any roadblocks they've encountered, and more. Last but not least is communication. Asana is perfect for this. Not just in the sense of reducing meetings, but in general with providing the ability to clearly explain different components of projects, ask quick questions, and share progress. This benefit is key, especially since so many teams are working remotely these days. Asana is also a great tool for teams and industries across the board. Some common use cases include marketing teams using it to manage a content calendar, product teams using it for launches, and HR using it for internal purposes. Our marketing team at Jotform uses it to keep track of the content we produce each month, for product launches, public relations tracking, and much more. Okay, so now that we have an overview of what Asana is, let's jump into a brief tutorial on how to get started. First, head to asana.com, then click on the Try for Free tab in the upper right-hand corner and enter your email. Next, fill out the prompts until you reach the page that says, "Let's set up your first project." This is where the fun begins. I'm going to use a launch as an example. Now, let's include a few examples of tasks we might have to launch. We'll start with competitor research, landing page design, and PR. With our first few tasks in place, we can choose how to organize them. Asana's default is to do, doing, and done. Seems pretty clear, let's go with that. Now we have some layout options to choose from. List, board, timeline, and calendar. Let's go with board this time around. We can always change it later. On the next screen, we can include any teammates' email addresses who are working with us on this launch. You can then choose to purchase a plan or continue for free. Let's continue with the free limited version for now. Okay, now that we're in the board, we can see our three tasks: competitor research, landing page design, and PR as cards. Let's click into the first card, competitor research, and check out the customization options. Here we can choose to add an assignee, due date, which project we want to add to, what level of priority it is, a description, and any subtasks. Better yet, you can even add subtasks within subtasks. In the description, Asana allows you to bold, italicize, underline, and strike through. You can also include bullet points, emojis, and at others on your team. And at the bottom of each card, you can check on the history to keep track of who added to or edited the card. Now let's head back to the main board. If you check out the top, there are three options to change your board to a list, timeline, calendar, and more. The upper panel of the board also has some great features. For example, to add a little flair to your board, click on the gray square in the upper left-hand corner and choose a color and icon to spice things up a bit. And to start a new project, task, conversation, or invite, simply click on the pink plus sign. Below the upper panel, you can easily filter or sort your projects by the parameters you set. This comes in handy if you have countless tasks to keep track of. You'll be able to catch which ones need to get done the soonest. There you can also dive into rules, apps, fields, and more. Lastly, you can toggle the left side panel open to access your home, tasks, inbox, portfolios, goals, favorites, reports, and projects. You can also toggle the panel closed to keep full focus on the board you're working on. This is a great starting point for you and your team. If you like using the product, there are many more customization options to choose from, so you can decide which one works best for you. In summary, Asana is an all-around amazing project management tool and can be used for organizing, tracking, and managing complex projects. Thank you so much for watching our guide on how to use Asana. We hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.